gentlemen, it is me, Viktor Dmitrievich Huliganov, coming to you with a little talk, bearing in mind that today is the end of second year of my existence, because I was thought up precisely the day after the day of today, which is 26th of May, and I first appeared on 27th of May 2006, one day after the producer of me got the webcam for the birthday present. So the first thing what happened was webcam goes on top of computer, my sort of person who created me was mucking around in front of a webcam what he got from his mommy and daddy, and all of a sudden out pops Huliganov, even though he of course been doing Huliganov of sorts for many years, even since he was little boy, because he always have these big eyebrows, and so he always tried to be a little bit like Brezhnev or do a Brezhnev kind of character. But the fully fledged Viktor Huliganov popped into life 2 years ago. So I've been around for 2 years. What have I done? Well, so far I did some Russian lessons, a few songs, jokes, things like that, and people seem to enjoy it, so maybe I carry on for a bit longer. I have no intention of disappearing. Some people say, you know, he is like Borat, but Borat is gone now. This person, this Sasha Baron Cohen, who is really Englishman, not really Kazakhstanian, he decided not to do any more Borat, and so Borat just disappeared. But I have it on writing that I'm going to be around for a lot longer. So I make sure, before I start to put myself out in any way, that I get a proper contract, not like Borat, but he is like a kind of clown. Not a clone, a clown. Please notice extra letter. So, in any event, what I wanted to talk about here on this second anniversary is that man's conquests, man's attempts to increase his power, his frontiers, appear to be unstoppable. Not only is he now content with having, or not content with having covered the whole world and caused global warmings, but also he's now going on to other planets. Today I read in a newspaper about human being already sending probe to Mars, and they arrive on Mars, and in a couple of Martian days time they going to make this arm digging into the ground to try to find out if there is ice, what is underground, and if it is ice, whether this has always been the ice, or if it's been the water, and if it's been the water, if it's got the life in it, and if it's life on Mars, then do they eat Mars bars? But these questions, which are of interest to the whole of humanity, seem to overlook one thing. If there is life on Mars, and it is intelligent life, then what do they even think about the fact that we've gone and sent something up there what looked like a weapon? They could seriously have caused us to get into big problems now, because they might start to send some things back, and those things might not be as innocent as what we sent out there. So, you know, you have to consider these NASA people. You might have put us all into a big risk now. I hope you know. I hope you're satisfied. Because if you want us to have these tripod things like this, look, I got one here. It was from the film. Yeah, this one's with like gorilla feet. And they go walking like this. And it goes, ooh, yeah, ooh, yeah. And it goes shooting all over the place. If you want that to happen, then what you're doing is the right way to go about it. But anyway, I don't want to in any way for my words to be interpreted as dampening the zeal of human beings always to push forward their barriers. But it should be the personal barrier what is holding me back or you back from being the human being what you want to be. The message of this video is, No, that wasn't the message of the video. The message of the video is, it's never too late to be the human being, the person that you want to be. You can start to be this person today. I'm not sure what Wesley it was, whether it was John Wesley or Charles Wesley or Elvis Wesley, but one of the Wesley brothers said, today I hope to begin to be a Christian. And the people said to him, well, that's a bit funny because you're already our minister. And you've been a professing Christian for many years. So what you mean to say today you hope to begin to be a Christian? It's a bit funny, don't you think? What we've been paying your salary for if you're not really Christian? But in fact what he said was very profound. No matter what you've done up till now, don't rest upon your laurels and hardies, but always press forward to become what you really want to be. Treat today like it was the first day of the rest of your lives. And this should be your quest, to work out what you want to be and to behave and pretend like you have no history, but are always going to be the person that you want to be, the image what you want to be. Don't say to yourself, oh, I am too limited, I can't be, I want to be like him, I want to be like her, I want to be this great person, but I am too limited, I have never been like this. Today is the first day of the rest of your life. If you want to be like this or you want to be like this, this is the first day in which you can be. If you've been somebody who up till now have not been able to smoke, rather most people are able to smoke if they want to, not been able to stop smoking, make today the day when you're giving it up. If you've been drinking alcohol and you haven't been able to give it up, make today the day when you are giving it up. If you have anything else what you need to change about your life, yeah, don't consider that in the past you tried and failed to do it. You always have a new chance as long as you live. Dum spiro spero. Lord's mercies are new every morning, is what he says in the psalm. So if you haven't been the person that you wanted to be so far in your life, then you know where to go. You can go to the Lord, you can say, Lord, I read that your mercies are new every morning, and today I got a new morning. Thank you for this new morning. Please give me the mercies to be better person, to be the kind of person I want to be, and to give you the glory for it. And I believe that you will be given new mercies to be the person that you want to be the person that God has designed and created you to be. It is the devil who is continually holding you back with memories of past failures. Don't listen to his whisperings, but press to the mark and become the person that God is calling you to be. So, should be the quest. Not so much going to different planets, going to different systems of solar or whatever, but to really push back the boundaries, the frontiers of the working of sin and iniquity in your own personality, to press back the weaknesses and infirmities, and to find a quest in becoming the person that you want to be, having the characteristics that you admire in some other people that you would like to have in yourself. Please to consider this as a quest, and I want right now to sing a little song. It is unfortunately in French, but nothing's perfect. Thank you for new mail. It's about the quest of following the impossible star. But I don't believe that perfection is possible in this life. But you still are able, by the refreshing working of God's mercies, to improve on what was before and to press towards something better. And this is a quest. And so I'm singing La Quête, sometimes called The Impossible Dream from The Man of La Mancha, but it's by Jack Brel. And I want to sing this song for you today, at the end of this second year, in the hope that the next years will be better. I'm not saying that the ones so far have been bad, but always we press to be even better. Pour atteindre l'inaccessible étoile. Let's have a try of this and see how well we manage it. Rêver un impossible rêve, porter le chagrin des départs, brûler d'une possible fièvre, partir où personne ne part. Aimer jusqu'à la déchirure, aimer même trop, même mal, tenter sans force et sans armure d'atteindre l'inaccessible étoile. Telle est ma quête, suivre l'étoile. Peu m'importe mes chances, peu m'importe le temps ou ma désespérance, et puis lutter toujours. Sans question ni repos, se donner pour l'or d'un mot d'amour. Je ne sais si je serai ce héros, mais mon cœur serait tranquille. Et les villes s'éclabousseraient de bleu, parce qu'un malheureux brûle encore, bien qu'ayant-tu brûlé, brûle encore, même trop, même mal, pour atteindre à s'en écarteler, pour atteindre l'inaccessible étoile. It was pretty sucky, wasn't it? But that's because everything's really quiet here. I don't know why it's so quiet. I can't get the sound to go up properly high on this. Sorry about that. This is very sucky version, but what can you do? Just hope that the next time is better. That's the quest. The impossible dream. You have to reach it. L'inaccessible étoile.